A very good morning to all of you. Today we are going to learn a very important and interesting topic, which is known as reported speech. In other words, it is also called as direct and indirect speech. So now just think about it. What do you mean by direct and indirect? Why the speech is divided into two parts? The definition of direct speech. So direct speech means, suppose if the words of the speaker is quoted exactly as it is known as direct speech. And if it is quoted by making some necessary changes, then it is known as indirect speech. So there are two types of speeches, direct and indirect speech. It is also known as narration or reported speech. So let's see. So direct or quoted speech. Why it is known as quoted speech? Because the exact words of the speaker are quoted as it is in double inverted commas. Now there is a difference in writing the direct speech and indirect speech. The direct speech is written, as we said, that the words are quoted exactly. So they have to be quoted in certain way. So they are quoted in double inverted commas. Whereas in indirect speech, you know, there is no comma is used, neither the double inverted commas are used. So direct or quoted speech involves quoting the exact words uttered by the person or the speaker within inverted commas or quotation marks. For example, she said, "I won't be coming home tonight." Now here the speaker is she, it's a girl. Now her words, her exact words, whatever she had quoted before, those words are written in double inverted commas. That's why this sentence is known as direct speech. Now if we have to change it into indirect speech, there are different rules that we have to follow. Suppose if we are seeing affirmative sentence, if we are learning direct speech or indirect speech of affirmative sentence or assertive sentence, there are different rules which have to be followed. Now if we are changing an imperative sentence, means a command or a request type of sentence, different rules are there. So for every particular sentence, the different rules are there which we have to follow while changing them from direct speech into indirect speech. Now if this sentence we have to change into indirect way of speaking, what would be the answer? Before that, we'll just see what is the definition of indirect speech. So indirect or reported speech does not have to be within quotes or reported word to word, or it is quoted after making some necessary important changes. For example, "I won't be coming home tonight," she said. So what would be the indirect speech of it? She said that she won't be able to coming home that night. So tonight will get changed into that night. So these are the different examples of direct and indirect. He said, "I am fine." Now the exact words of this boy is quoted in double inverted commas. That is why it is included in direct speech. Now when we remove comma and the punctuation marks and the double inverted commas, the answer would be, "He said that he was fine." Now here different rules, as I said, we have to, there are changes in all the different tenses. Suppose if it is about present tense, now let's talk about present tense. Simple present tense is the first subpart of present tense. Simple present tense changes into simple past tense. Second is present continuous tense. Present continuous tense changes into past continuous tense. The third is present perfect tense. Present perfect tense gets changed into past perfect tense. And likewise, the last one is present perfect continuous tense, which gets automatically changed into past perfect continuous tense while changing a sentence from direct speech into indirect speech. Components of direct and indirect speech. Now the different components are there of a direct speech sentence. For example, it can be divided into two parts, two important parts: reporting part and reported part. Now what is a reporting part? The reporting part is something which is outside the inverted commas. It contains main verb. It is called as reporting verb. Now see, let's take an example. Maya said, "Radha is my friend." So Maya said, the words which are written before comma before the punctuation mark comma, it is known as reporting part. Now here, this is the reporting part. Maya said is the reporting part and said is the reporting verb. Now the part which is there in double inverted commas. Now which is the double inverted commas? Which is written, Radha is my friend, is written in double inverted commas. Now this part or this sentence which is quoted by the speaker and it is written as it is in the direct speech is known as reported speech, right? So there are two components. Now basically there are three components: reporting part, reporting verb and reported speech. Now let's take another example. Anoop said to me, sit down there. Now Anoop said to me is outside the double inverted commas and before comma it is a reporting part, whereas said is the reporting verb, similar that we have seen in the previous question. Sit down there, it is quoted by the speaker and it is written as it is in double inverted commas, that's why it is known as reported speech. Now there are various rules to change a direct speech into indirect speech. These can be classified according to the different kinds of sentences of the reported speech. Now there are different kinds of sentences that we speak. Some sentences are negative, some are assertive, some are interrogative. There are question WH type of questions. Okay, question form of sentences, optative sentences. What are optative sentences? Like wishing something, wishes which includes prayer, wish, curse, etc. Exclamatory sentences, okay, which is which signifies the use of exclamation mark, okay, exclamation. So these are the different kinds of sentences. Now every sentence has various kinds of rules to follow while we change a sentence into from direct speech into indirect speech. So let's take it one by one. Now important rules to keep in mind. Now these are the general rules which you have to keep in mind while changing a direct speech into indirect speech. Inverted commas are removed in indirect speech. So when we change a sentence from direct speech into indirect, first of all what we have to do, we have to remove the comma and the inverted commas. So then what we will put instead of that? Second rule, comma after the reporting verb is also removed, as I just told you. Rule number 3, there is no change in the tense of the reporting verb. If the reporting verb is linked to some object, a person or a person's name, said to is changed to told, and similarly says to, says, say to or says to is changed to tell or tells. But if the reporting verb is without an object, then there is no change. Said, say, says remain as they are. What does it mean? Now, suppose the reporting part. Now, what I'm talking about, we have just seen the reporting part which is outside the comma and outside the double inverted commas. That part is known as reporting part. Now, if the reporting verb is in present tense, suppose if I say, he says, comma, double inverted commas, I am going to market. Inverted commas close, full stop. Now when we change this sentence into indirect speech, the tense will not get changed and the tense will remain as it is. How? He says, I will go to the market or I am going to the market. So he says that he is going to the market, we do not change it. But if the reporting part is in past tense, how? If it is having said, if the reporting verb is present as said to, suppose he said comma double inverted commas, I am going to the market. So now the sentence or the reported part is in the present continuous tense, it will change into past continuous tense. So what will be the answer? He said that he was going to the market. So present continuous tense changed into past continuous tense while changing this sentence into from direct into indirect speech. Rule number 4, a conjunction that is used to join the reporting verb and reported speech. Now when you are breaking the sentence, so the sentence, when we have to break the sentence or we have to join the sentence. Now in the direct speech, the reported part is written in inverted commas, double inverted commas. Now how to remove the double inverted commas and the comma. For removing these punctuation marks, we have to use a conjunction. What is a conjunction? Conjunction is a joining word like that, beside, between, in spite of, instead, etc. So here, to make this sentence as one sentence or to remove the punctuation marks from direct into indirect, we will use the conjunction that. So a conjunction that is used to join the reporting verb and reported speech. Changes in tense forms, pronouns and words indicating nearness of time and position are also made. Now this point we'll see in a slide. Now what is nearness of time and position? Like for example, if the sentence of direct speech contains today, tomorrow, yesterday, day after tomorrow, how will it change into indirect speech? That we will see it. Changes in the tenses. As I have already discussed with you a couple of minutes back, now these are the sentences of present tense. So in present tense, if it is there in the direct speech, if the reported speech is in present tense, it will change into indirect, it will change into simple past. I play football. He said that he played football. Right? So in the simple past tense, we use the second form of the verb. So see here, it's use second form of the verb and the object. Present continuous. If the reported speech is in the present tense, it gets changed into present past continuous tense. I am cutting a tree. He said that he was cutting a tree. You know the structure of past continuous. It contains a subject, was verb plus first form of the verb plus ing plus object. Present perfect. I have eaten food. Now here the reported speech is in present perfect tense. It will change into past perfect tense. What is the formula for past perfect tense? Or what is the rule? It contains a subject plus had plus third form of the verb plus object. So see, I have eaten food. He said that he had eaten food. Now let's talk about the past tense. If the sentence or the reported speech is in the simple past, it changes into past perfect tense. Past perfect, subject plus had plus V3 plus object. I drove the car. He said that he had driven a car. Past continuous changes into past perfect continuous. I was coming. He said that he had been coming. Past perfect, I have come. Past perfect changes to past perfect. Simple past. Present perfect tense changes into past perfect tense. Right? Now these are the different models. Will, would, can, could, should, might. They are very easy. Will gets changed into would. Can gets changed into could. Should gets changes into should. And may gets changed into might. Let's see different examples. I would help. He said that he would help. I can carry bags. He said that he could carry bags. I could help. He said that he could help. Now here the sentence is already, you know, in the past form. Now here could is indicating the past form of can. So while changing this into the indirect speech, it will remain as it is. So similarly about should and might. Now these are the changes in the pronouns. When we change a sentence from direct speech into indirect speech, these are the changes which happen in the pronoun. For example, if I is there in the direct speech, for example, she said, comma, double inverted commas, I go to the morning walk. I go to a morning walk. Now she said that she goes to the morning walk. Because here I'm talking about myself, she said that I go to the morning walk. Now here it will automatically change into she. If we is there, it gets changed into they. And similarly, likewise, all these changes are made in different pronouns. Changes in the words indicating nearness of time and position. Now, if you remember, in the rule number 5, I told you that there will be changes in the nearness of time and position, in the words that indicate nearness of time. Now, which are the words that indicate nearness of time and position? These are the different words that indicate this, there, now, here, today, tomorrow, yesterday, last day, last night. These are the different words. These indicate the nearness of time and position. Now, they get changed into, suppose if this is there in the sentence of direct speech. I live in this house. What would be the indirect speech? She lived in that house. So this got ultimately changed into that. Then changes into those. Now changes into then. Here changes into there. Today gets changes into that day. So these are the different changes that occur while changing a sentence from direct into indirect speech. For example, let's take an example, direct speech and indirect speech. I will call you tomorrow. Now, how will it changed into indirect speech? Tomorrow will be changed into the next day. So he said that he would call me the next day. This would be the answer. Now let's take the second. Now here we were discussing about the affirmative or the assertive type of sentences. Now we will talk about the questions or the interrogative sentences. Now questions or interrogative sentences means asking questions. Okay, these are the interrogative types of sentences. What would be now here when you change from direct into indirect, there are different rules which you have to follow. First of all, let's talk about the interrogative sentences. Change the following into indirect speech. She said to me, have you seen my friend? Now the interrogative sentences, they begin with the helping verbs like is, am, are, was, where, do, does, did, has, have, had. Okay, and the WH type of the question sentences starts with what, where, how, when, etc. So suppose she said to me, have you seen my friend? What would be the answer or how will you convert it into an indirect speech? She asked me, because it is a question, you will not write told me or said to me. You have to write, she asked me. And which is the conjunction that you will use? You will not use that here. You will either use if or whether. She asked me if I had seen her friend. Why? Because the reported speech was in the present perfect and it got changed into past perfect and with the connective if. Let's take another example. Kohinoor said to me, did you see me? Kohinoor asked me if I had seen her. Now here, if the sentence begins with did, so while changing this sentence into indirect speech, you will not use did in the answer. Did will get removed and instead of it you will use the second form of the verb which is present in the reported speech. Here, which is the verb present? See. Now what is the second form of see? Saw. Now since this sentence is in simple past, it will change into past perfect and that's what it has done. Kohinoor asked me if I had seen her and you will not use did. Now the same rule goes for interrogative sentences starting with did or do. If it is in simple present, if it is an interrogative sentence in simple present, it will change into simple past. If it is in simple past, it will change into past perfect. Let's take one more example. You said to me, don't I love you more than Rahman? You asked him if you didn't love him more than Rahman. This would be the answer. Why? Because this is a negative simple present tense in interrogative form. So what would be the answer? It will be again in the negative form but in the simple past form or in the simple past tense. Let's take the sentences that begin with the WH type. As I told you, now here also you will not use any conjunction, neither if nor whether and even not that. Kamla said, who breaks it? Kamla asked, who broke it? Because the question is in the simple present, it's a simple present question, it will change into simple past question. So Kamla said, who broke that? You do not have to add any connective in between. in the WH form of the direct speech of sentences. Okay, now let's talk about the imperative sentences. Now, what are imperative sentences? Imperative sentences, they indicate commands or request, order, advice, suggestion. Imperative sentences are those which express order, command, and advice. The word said changes into tell, request, suggestion. If the reporting part is in present tense, if it is in says, say, then it will change into tell, request, suggestion, or if it is in the past tense. Suppose if the word said is there, if the verb is there, said, in the reporting part, it will change into request, suggestion, permit, asked, advice, warn, etc. For example, she said, get out of my way. Now here, by looking at the sentence, by looking at the reported speech, we come to know that it is a kind of order, or it's not an advice at all for sure, and neither a suggestion. It is a kind of an order. So here, instead of told, here it should have been, she ordered me to take an advice or an order or suggestion. Likewise, you have to change it into indirect way of speaking. Now let's take another example, direct speech, open the door. Now here it's clearly seen as an order. So the answer would be, he ordered me to open the door. One more sentence, don't answer the phone. Reported speech would be, she told me not to answer the phone. Let's take one more example, don't be back late. He ordered me not to be back late. Alright, so we will end the class here and we will continue the direct and indirect speech in our next.